Good morning students, a happy day for all. Today in this video lesson we shall learn about mitochondria. Where do you find mitochondria? See, I have shown you a diagram, two diagrams, plant cell, animal cell. That means eukaryotic cells and a small organelles arrowed there. That's only mitochondria. See how very small inside a cell it is. The organelle mitochondria is enlarged here. It's a filamentous granular cytoplasmic granules discovered by Kolliker in 1857. It was first seen in striated muscles. Mitochondria produces adenosine triphosphate. See, currency is so valuable. Similarly, ATP is also valuable. Adenosine triphosphate is also very valuable. Since it is produced inside the mitochondria, mitochondria is referred as powerhouse of the cell. The mitochondria is 0.5 millimicron to 2 millimicron. So mu, look at the word or the font used for millimicron. So it's important. Okay. Now let's see the structure of mitochondria in detail. It has two membranes, inner and outer membrane. Each membrane is 60 to 70 angstrom thick. The outer membrane contains enzymes, proteins and lipids. The protein here are particularly called porin molecules and they form channels for passage of molecule. Next one is inner membrane. It is semi-permeable. So this is what the difference between outer and inner membrane. Outer membrane lets everything to pass inside, whereas inner membrane selects the material or selects the molecule and let them inside. So it's called semi-permeable, rich in enzymes, carrier proteins and lipids. Regulates the passage of materials. Third one, cristae. Some finger-like projections increases the surface area and it holds variety of enzymes. So what are cristae? Cristae are the finger-like projections formed from the inner membrane towards the matrix. It's called cristae. Next one, oxysome. Along the lining of the cristae, there are some racket-shaped particles called F1 particles. These are called oxysomes, which involve in ATP synthesis. Matrix. Matrix is the media where you find lot of protein, lipids and enzymes used for Krebs cycle. It also contains 70S ribosomes and mitochondrial DNA and tRNA, transfer RNA. Next is the function of mitochondria. Mitochondria produces ATP molecules and so it's called powerhouse or ATP factory of the cell. Second function is it maintains concentration of calcium ions. So second one, maintains concentration of calcium ions. Third one, regulates metabolic activity of the cell. So controlled cell activity, metabolic activity of the cell. So three important mitochondrial function is given, produces ATP molecules, and therefore it is referred as powerhouse or ATP factory of the cell, maintains concentration of calcium ions, regulates metabolic activity of the cell. Today's assignment, explain the structure of mitochondria, what are oxysomes, write the function of mitochondria. So there are three questions, find the answers, study the answers, write down in your science notebook, get it signed from your parent with date. Is it clear? Okay, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you, girls. See you in the next class. Have a nice day.